Hello, welcome to Before the Vow. Today I want to talk about acquiring properties with your spouse. Before you get married, you should communicate with your spouse how both of you can acquire your properties together. And let that communication include both of you doing it together. Don't allow him to tell you that you will take care of the home and my money will take care of our projects, because anything can happen. When I got married, within the 8 months that I spent with him in Accra, God opened doors for us. And the doors included, during that time, we bought a land together. During that time, we opened the media school. And during that time, I came with two cars. And life became like the blessing in abundance. What we were not even expecting to happen happened within the space of 8 months during the time I was there. Because I thought that I was living a life with him and it's for the sake of our children, everything that I did it with my whole heart. And I trusted him that we are going to do it together. So whatever that I came home with, I gave it to him. The next thing was his fridge. He said his fridge is old and he wanted to buy a new one, and he asked one of his colleagues to come and take the fridge away without my consent. So don't worry, I'm going to buy a new fridge, and don't worry, I'm going to surprise the new fridge. He went to the shop and his money was not even sufficient. He had to call me and I rushed there with my card to pay for the extra fee of the fridge. I decided to throw a surprise birthday party for him. I remember very well that birthday party because we had a lot of issues in the past. And we went to mountain to pray all over everything that we had gone through. So it was like a new beginning, a fresh start. That birthday surprise party that I threw for him, a year, exactly a year, they asked him whether he has had a birthday party surprise like that before. And he said no. That surprise birthday party, I did it with my own money, thinking we are starting all over. And that was the beginning of the time that I resigned. And that same period, he just came back from abroad, from my family home, with my own invitation, speaking to my family to at least allow him come and sleep in their home. Initially, they hesitated because they remember the thing that he did to me in the past when he went for another woman and said he had divorced. But I told him it's his past. He is a new person. And you even see that he's a man of God. So allow him to be there. So when he came back, I felt like everything is new again. That birthday party, that was the beginning of our life in Accra. Later, he got to know other people in his life, and they were giving him more than I could give him. That was the beginning of my falls. It wasn't an easy situation for me in Accra, but I had to swallow because nobody would even believe whatever that I would say. Anybody that I managed to have courage to speak to, they thought I was just making noise. Because this guy doesn't look like anybody who would be like that. Who could even do this to you? Even when it wasn't easy for me to smile, I would pretend and smile and say all is well. Until I noticed that it wasn't well with me. But I tried to be strong, at least for myself and for my pregnancy. But when the time came that I couldn't hold on to my life, I had to flee. I stayed in Takoradi for a month. He never stepped foot there. And during that time I was in Takoradi, that was when he was enjoying his life. Even the day that I was traveling to abroad, he never picked my call. I shed tears. Tears that even if he had picked my call, I would choose not to go. I had to leave. But after I left, that was when he was planning, changing every name of our property into somebody else's name so that I lose everything. So I could see that the marriage was not for me, it was for him, so that he can get everything for me. For him to survive. Now, about the land, the help of a third party, we could acquire a property that was already owned by someone that we both knew. So we went there together to get a property. He had a small room, you know, built on the land. And by God's grace, we were able to, you know, build and pay. But because I trusted him, whatever that we were doing, I wasn't, you know, thinking that he could do anything wrong to me. So the first thing that I said, after we paid for the land, I said, oh, why don't we change the name into our name? Because anything can happen. They can even travel. And to be difficult for us to transfer it from their name to our name. So he doesn't care. Even if they don't transfer it to our name, he doesn't even care. I was shocked that how can he trust someone like that and say he don't care? No, no, and behind the back of his mind, he had his own agenda. He asked me, oh, why don't you sell your car so that we go and buy some blocks onto the land? I did it. Oh, you know, our business, you had investments. Why are you keeping it in investment? Whereby we are having a business, go and bring the money so that we invest. I did it. And even we used some of that money to even pay for the land. And everything that we did, I felt like I'm in the house. So let me use my money to take care of the home. Even though sometimes you come and buy some few things, but especially when I brought his parents to our home, I was transferring money from my account to take care of them. After all, it is both of us. I don't need to come and account and say this is coming from me. It was the two of us. There got to a time I noticed that the quarrel and the fight and all those things were becoming too much. And the third party who led us to the land told me that the guy has said that he wants to sell the property because I'm going to fight over property with him. The moment I left, he spoke to a common friend of ours that he should let him transfer the name into his name. No, no, he has already gone to see the landlord to transfer the name into his name that I was not even aware. So imagine, you say you have a husband that you want to spend the rest of your life with. So whatever that you do it with him together. But he had a different agenda. Fast forward, I noticed he was selling the property. Because he wanted to sell the property and I knew that we did it together, even when I traveled, he was communicating with me, sending me pictures. This is where I've gotten to. If I don't send you money, don't worry, because I'm using the school money to the profit that we get from the media school to fast track building that house so that you can come with my baby. That time I was pregnant. So I felt like, okay, let me also struggle and take care of the children here. The next moment I saw that he was selling the property. And you too, I had not heard from you for over 1 year. So if you're selling the property, then why don't you sell it for both of us to get, you know, split? And the media school too, you have taken everything since I left. But you know, everything that I got from the school, because I thought that I was marrying, I could sign from the school, bring the money home, and he'll collect it. And because I thought I was giving it to my husband, I didn't even ask him to sign. After I left, he used the signature of mine in the school and said that I have stolen everything that we had from the school. You see, you think that you are married. So I'm just saying this for you to know that just be vigilant. Open your eyes, because you might think that you are married to someone that you trust, but the person is doing something behind your back that you have no idea. If he has good intentions or she has good intentions for you, it is bonus. But make sure that you see everything that he does. Or sometimes some men think that, let me leave everything in the care of the woman and let me take care of other things. And the woman will be doing everything because she thinks she's smart. She'll do everything in her name. Oh, after I'm the woman. And you will come back and you get nothing. So all these things that I was doing, I trusted him that he should do it and he should do it. He transferred everything into someone else's name. And the school, he transferred it into his parents' name. Meanwhile, his parents have not opened any school. So now he is saying that he has had an encounter. He knows God and he is a man of God. After all that, he was able to lie in the court that we have no property. I gave the address, everything, that this is a property, and he's selling it. If he's selling, I don't have a problem, but he should give me my share because I have also invested in the property. He was able to look in my eye and look into the judge's eye and say that we have no property. And before God and man, both of us know that we have a property. Upon all that I did, proving with evidence, even the witness, the person who sold the property to us, came to testify on my behalf. I sold it. He even comes home and eats in my home. I even cook and send it to his house. We were attending the same church together. Someone who says that he's a man of God stood in the box and said he doesn't know the woman just because of greediness, just because of property, vanity, material gain. He took everything. So, okay, from the very first day that we met, that your mattress was on the floor, I was buying you medicine, even as of 2014, 900 Ghana cedis for medication every month. I signed my check and gave it to the hospital. I did all that. You come around, I give you money. When you are sick, I'm there. I sacrifice my time, my youth, my money, everything, even serving you and your family. I even helped his junior brother to get job in the mines, and I couldn't sleep until I got him a job. And now that junior brother claims he is somebody, that he can insult me. So sometimes when you're getting married to somebody, you need to do background checks. You might think that you are marrying from a Christian home, but that family are full of, you know, it's like a wolf in sheep clothing. They will come and claim that they know God. They will come and preach righteousness and the kingdom of God to people, but deep down within them, what they are doing has no resemblance with the word of God. I decided to make this video to tell the young ones out there that gone are the days that you make a man do everything and you also do things in the house. They can easily make you lose everything. Anything can happen. It can be your fault, it can be his fault, and there will be a marriage breakup. At the end of the day, what you need to know is you did something together for the sake of peace. And since I am going with my children, I have tried to fight and fight and fight for the survival of the marriage. And he has also tried to fight and fight and fight for the collapse of the marriage. So if you don't want the marriage anymore, then what we did together, let me have my share and go. After all, I am the one taking care of the children. They are in my care. I need to get something. And you need to compensate me for all the time that I have wasted with you and all the things that I have wasted on you. He said he's not going to give me anything. And the court was able to give him everything, including the no compensation. And he feels like he has won. You have won what? At the end of the day, the marriage is over. Because you lied to the court that you don't have anything, you have won. Oh no. Let me tell the young men out there, don't think that you can fool a woman. A woman who has wholeheartedly given you your all, karma is real. The woman might not say anything to you. She might move on with her life. But saying, speaks a lot. If you want God to bless you, don't cheat. Don't make a fool out of any woman who has toiled with you, who saw your beginning and didn't care. Because what goes around comes around. As I am educating the women, educate the men to let them know that karma is real. If you have lived a life with somebody and you don't want to continue anymore, look at your past, how you have struggled together. At least have some conscience and some remembrance. Some people forget so easily. They forget where they came from. They forget that it was somebody who worked together with them before they got to where they are. When they get there, then they think they did it all by themselves. Vanity is vanity. At least I'm happy the way I am right now. I have my peace of mind. I have my children. I have my life back. But I am advising you, the youth out there, that before you enter into marriage, plan with your spouse to be, how you're going to acquire your properties together. Don't let them do it alone. Even if you pay for anything, make sure you have a copy of every receipt. Make sure you have a copy of every indenture. Whatever that you do, you too have your copy. And never allow them to try. If you both of you are paying for the property, make sure that they change it in both of you your name. Don't think that, okay, it is in his name, so when the marriage is over, so far as it's in his name, I have my share. They will transfer it into somebody else's name and they will say it doesn't belong to them. What are you going to do? And because it is in their name, transferring it to someone is so easy. So make sure it is in both of you your name. If you're going to buy cement, take a receipt. Because we thought that the person that we were buying the property from, we know them, so they never gave us a receipt. That same person who came to testify, so far as she was not able to provide a receipt, her witness or her testimony doesn't say anything. So you might think that I'm living a life with somebody, but the person has an ulterior motive. It has happened to me, but I don't want it to happen to you. Make sure you do everything together. If he has good intentions for you, it is bonus. If he has no good intentions for you, then you know that at least you were able to see through everything that you were doing together. But if you leave everything in their care that they should handle it and let me take care of the home, they don't even see that you have done something for them in the home. They come and eat from what you have put, so that you have cooked for them free. They have taken your ideas for free. So you enter into marriage and give everything to them for free, and they say they have nothing with you, they have no compensation for you. They always say that God will fight for you, but I'm telling you that be vigilant before we get to that level that God will fight for you. So my message to you today is about how you can discuss with your spouse the way you acquire your properties together. Don't leave everything in their care, and don't allow them to manipulate you to allow them do it by themselves and say, you take care of this, let me take care of that. Okay, then let them take care of the home and you take care of the properties. Go do the up and down of the properties. If they don't have any bad intentions, then they should let you also be directly involved. Even me, that I was directly involved, it got to a time they saw that I was knowing too much. So they have to let me leave. If I leave them quickly, they will change everything. And he did that with the help of his family. They think that they have won, but God is our fighter. Today it is me, but tomorrow don't let it be you. Listen to the advice that I have for you and be extra vigilant. Let acquiring of properties be part of your communication, be part of your plan. Do it together before somebody makes a fool out of you. Until I come your way again next time, thank you for watching and bye-bye.